This is Janet Andrabir.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to apply the work energy theorem, the conservation of mechanical energy, and its relation with internal energy in order to solve our problem, which is about a car moving under the action of the traction force, under the action of the braking force, and under the action of its weight.
In this problem, we study the motion of a car along the track OABCD. A car taken as a particle of mass 1000 kg starts moving on the horizontal road from point O. Now, we will take the gravitational acceleration as 10 meters per second squared. We neglect air resistance and the mass of the fuel. We consider the system: car, fuel, road, atmosphere, earth. And also, we take the horizontal plane containing O as a reference level for gravitational potential energy. Now, in the first part of the question, we will discuss the motion of the car between O and A. The car starts from rest under the action of the traction force. It reaches point A with a speed of 72 km per hour. So, at point O, the speed is VO equals 0. And at point A, the speed is VA 72 km per hour, and it is equal to 20 meters per second, as you know. Now, part A. Indicate whether this system is energy isolated. Now, if we go back to our system, car, fuel, road, atmosphere, earth, this system does not exchange energy with its surroundings. So, the system car, fuel, road, atmosphere, earth is energy isolated.
Part B. Calculate the mechanical energy of the system at O and at point A. At point O, the mechanical energy at O is given by KE at O plus PE at O. KE at O equal 1/2 mVO squared plus mgHO. But we know that VO equals 0 since it started from rest, and HO also 0 since O belongs to the reference level of a gravitational potential energy. Therefore, the mechanical energy of the system at point O is equal to 0. Then at point A, similarly, MEA equal KEA plus PEA. So MEA equal 1/2 MVA squared plus MGHA. Now, substitute for M equal 1,000 kilograms, VA equal 20 meters per second. A also belongs to the reference level of a gravitational potential energy. So HA is 0. So MGHA equals 0. Therefore, the mechanical energy at A equal to 2 times 10 to the power 5 joules. Now part C. Deduce the variation in the internal energy of the above system during the motion between O and A. Justify the sign of this variation. The variation in the internal energy means you have to calculate delta U. Since the system is energy isolated as proved in part A, then we can write delta U equal minus delta ME. Delta ME between O and A equal MEA minus MEO. MEA is just calculated in part B, which is 2 times 10 to the power 5. MEO is calculated also in part B, which is 0. Therefore, delta U equal minus 2 times 10 to the power 5 joules. Now, what does this minus sign represent? Since we have a combustion of fuel in the engine, so the fuel loses part of its internal energy. So, delta U is negative. Therefore, due to the fuel combustion, the loss in the internal energy is transformed into mechanical energy. For that, delta ME here is positive.
Now let's discuss the motion of the car between A and B. When the car reaches point A, the driver removes his foot from the accelerator pedal and he applies the brakes. So the car reaches point B 50 meters away from A with a speed of 10 meters per second. Now take into account that when the driver removes his foot from the accelerator pedal, the traction force becomes zero. Now take a look at the given. So we have the distance AB 50 meters and the speed of the car at point B is 10 meters per second. And the question is, apply the work energy theorem between A and B to determine the work done by the braking force F. Deduce the magnitude of this force. So these are two questions. So let's start with calculating the work done by the resistive friction. Our system, of course, is the car. And what are the external forces acting on the car during its motion between A and B? As you know, we have the weight of the car, the normal force acting on the car, and the braking force. Now let's go to the work energy theorem. Delta Ke from A to B is equal to sum of WFEXT. So the variation in the kinetic energy of the car as it moves from A to B is equal to the sum of the works of all the external forces acting between A and B. So this is going to be 1/2 mvb squared minus 1/2 mva squared is equal to the work done by mg plus the work done by m plus the work done by f. Let's start with the work done by mg and the work done by m. Look at the figure. M is perpendicular to the direction of motion. Also, mg is perpendicular to the direction of motion. So the work done by these forces is zero, since they are perpendicular to the direction of motion. Now let's go to the numerical application. So 1/2 into the mass of the car, 1000 kilogram. The speed at point B is 10 meter per second, minus 1/2 into 1000. Now, what is this 20? It is the speed at point A, and we had it in the previous parts. So this is equal to the work done by F, and the answer is minus 15 times 10 to the power 4 joule. Now, after calculating the work done by F, how can we calculate the magnitude of this force? Remember that the work done by a constant force is given by the formula F dot displacement vector. So what is the displacement vector? It is A, B. It is a vector joining the initial position A and the final position B. Now look at F and AB. They have opposite directions. So the scalar product will give you work done by F is equal to the magnitude of F times the magnitude of AB times cosine 180, the angle between them. Numerical application. So AB is 50 and cosine 180 is minus 1. So the answer is minus 15 times 10 to the power 4 joule. Now the magnitude of F will be finally 3000 newton.
Focus, please. This is important.
To be. Determine the variation in the internal energy of the system between A and B and justify the sign of this variation. As in part 1c, delta U equal minus delta ME. Delta ME between A and B equal MEB minus MEA. But we have to calculate the mechanical energy at B. MEB equal 1/2 MVB squared plus MGHB. Now, let's substitute for M equal 1000 kilograms, VB equal 10 meters per second, but B belongs to the reference level of a gravitational potential energy. So HB equal to zero. And then MGHB is also equal zero. Therefore, the mechanical energy at B equal 5 times 10 to the power 4 joules. Now, delta U equal minus MB, which is 5 times 10 to the power 4, minus ma, which is 2 times 10 to the power 5, we get delta U between A and B equal 15 times 10 to the power 4 joules. Now, what does this positive sign mean? Since we have a breaking force, and the work done by the breaking force results in a transformation of the kinetic energy into thermal energy. So, and the thermal energy is a part of the internal energy, so the internal energy increases, or delta U is greater than zero. Part 2c. Specify whether the microscopic kinetic energy or the thermal energy of the system varies according to the previous result. Since the kinetic energy is converted into thermal energy, so the thermal energy varies. The thermal energy of the system increases since the loss in the kinetic energy is converted into thermal energy.
Now let's study the motion of the car on the inclined plane. At point B, the driver removes his foot from the brake pedal and the car continues its motion along the inclined plane BCD, which makes an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal. Now take the traction force in this part as zero. And the question is, determine the speed of the car at point C, where KE equal GPE. Deduce the distance BC traveled by the car. So these are two questions. Let's start with calculating the speed at point C. We will calculate the speed at point C by using the conservation of mechanical energy. Now, some of the works done by the non-conservative forces is zero along the incline. So the mechanical energy is conserved. So we will have mechanical energy at point B is equal to mechanical energy at point C. Now, what is the mechanical energy at point C? It is KEC plus GPEC. Now, we replace from the given GPE by KE. So this is going to be 2KEC. Now, KEC is equal to 1/2 MVC squared. So this is going to be MVC squared. Now, look at the equation. We have MEB. We have already calculated it in the previous parts. And we have MVC squared. So now we can calculate VC. Let's go to the numerical application. Mechanical energy at B is 5 times 10 power 4 joule. The mass of the car is 1,000 kilogram. And now the answer is VC is equal to radical 50 or 7.07 meter per second. Now, after calculating VC, we must calculate the distance BC. Let's go back to our given. So KE at point C is equal to GPE at point C. Now, KEC is equal to 1/2 MVC squared. And GPE at point C is equal to MGHC. But what is HC? Look at the figure. This is HC. If you consider this right triangle, this one, okay? So sine 30 is equal to the opposite HC over the hypotenuse BC. So HC would be BC sine 30. So the m's cancel out. You still have 1/2. BC squared is 50. The gravity is 10. BC is unknown. And sine 30 is 0.5. It is going to be BC is equal to 5 meters.
Part 3b. The car stops at point D. Determine the height HD at this point. Since the mechanical energy is conserved along the inclined BCD, so we can apply the principle of conservation of mechanical energy between B and D. So MEB equal MED. We know the value of MEB calculated in the previous parts, but MED equal KED plus GPED. KED equals 0 since the car stops at the point D, and GPED equals mg HD to be determined. Now, substitute for MEB equal 5 times 10 to the power 4 joules, equal M, which is 1000 kilogram, G equal 10 meters per second squared, and times HD. Therefore, HD equal 5 meters. Finally, 3C. Calculate the variation in the internal energy of the system, car fuel, road atmosphere air, between B and D. Since the system is energy isolated, we can use this formula. Delta U between B and D equal minus delta ME, which is MED minus MEB. But the mechanical energy is conserved, so MED equal MEB. Then MED minus MEB equals zero. This is going to be delta U between B and D is also zero.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.